Comic Relief, a thought-provoking film about how even the closest relationships can crack under pressure. Richard Briers and Kevin Whatley star in Dad.
Say it's only a paper moon sailing over a cardboard sky, but it wouldn't be make-believe if you believe.
Oh, come on, love. Here you go. Now, hold very tight, please. There you go. Up we come. Up we come. You wonder where the yellow went when you brush your teeth with pet
soap. Pet soap.
Good girl.
Boiled eggs.
Are you stuck?
We're not having eggs this time of night. What am I, love?
Stuck. You're tangled up and stuck.
Here we go. Oh, now. Lift your legs.
Not stuck. What's the word, love?
Can I leave you for a minute? If I go to the loo, can I leave you?
Early start in the morning.
Probably, yes.
Laurie.
Yeah.
I know what I am. I'm mad. I've gone mad up here. I'm a mad.
No more than anyone else. Now then, I'm nipping downstairs for the newspaper. Have a read in the loo. You stay there, you all right? Good girl.
It. Well, you go on buggering around as per bloody usual. You ought to grow up, you do, Lawrence James.
Mr. James?
When am I going home?
I'll take fresh towels into your dad tonight.
If the consultant says he can come home tomorrow.
I'll stock him up a bit next week. There's no food in these cupboards.
He likes to get it in fresh every day. Gets him out of the house. These screws aren't long enough.
Are you doing your mum tonight? You'll only fret if you don't.
Right.
She enjoys seeing you.
She doesn't remember it 5 minutes later.
If I went senile, would you visit me?
You won't. We'll go down to Wakes. Get these screws.
If you go like me, Mum, I'll peel you grapes and feed you gherkins and chitterlings, yeah, and Bess Hazlitt. I am, Dad. Of course I will. Well, one of us sees her every day, you know that. No, Sandy's coming to you. Said something about towels. What, have they said that? Tomorrow?
The consultant hasn't shown up yet. Takes a long time, golf does.
It's his operating day.
So they say.
You know it, it... So no one's actually said you're coming home tomorrow?
10 o'clock.
Who says?
Me.
Just then.
Is she all right?
She's fine, Dad. It's a nice place. She's getting used to it.
She better not be. I'll have her home next week.
Look, I've got to go, Dad. I'm putting grab rails around the house.
When I want to live in an old people's bungalow, I let you know.
Bye, Dad.
You'd have been home last week if it wasn't for that chest infection.
Yeah, for all that standing around in water at Dunkirk.
We're all cleared up now. I see you'll be staying with your son for a couple of weeks.
Yes, this is my daughter-in-law.
You've managed well in the training kitchen. Walk into the bathroom.
With the iron horse, hi-ho, silver.
If we were to discharge you tomorrow, any worries?
None at all, no. You sorted me out very nicely.
We'll see you in clinic in 3 weeks to check that ankle.
Thanks, Mr. Hill, and thanks for everything you've done for me.
My pleasure. Oh.
Thanks.
Whoa! I feel like one of those four-wheel drive things with me bull bars.
How was she yesterday?
She's fine.
Well, what does that mean? Is she happy?
I don't know, Dad.
Of course you know.
You could have told us how bad she is.
What could you have done about it?
Oh, we could have come round a bit more, given you a breather. I mean, we knew she was
pretty forgetful. Come round enough as it is.
But she seemed to be able to cope. And if we'd known about the nights...
She's all right if you keep her to a routine. The doorbell, you standing there, she knew what to do, what to say. I like watching you with her. Tea and biscuits and just the odd slip-up.
First night. That night when I took you into the hospital. She just...
She doesn't always do it.
Why didn't you tell us? I mean, the special things you can put on the bed. You should be washing sheets every day.
You just open the door and chuck the sheet in. The machine does it all. She's not incontinent. She's just a deep sleeper. If you did it in the day, you'd worry.
Here we are, Dad. Summer house.
Polly Miller died in there.
She was 90.
Mere slip of a girl.
If we could have looked after her at home, we would.
You couldn't take weeks off work, I know that. There's some in that ward never had any visitors at all. I'd see you walking in straight after work and I'd say, here he comes, my lad.
Did you see the one where Joanna Lumley fell out the car flat in the face like her legs had gone to jelly?
Wait! I'll get you in frame.
Right.
Mr. James?
Hi. Yeah, this is the TV room.
The TV? Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah.
Her room's upstairs, but she'll be in the sunroom.
All right. Well then, Jeannie. How's your light brown hair? Oh. Well, I'm not good enough for you, eh? What are you waiting for? Secret sweetheart? Your warm coat. What do you wear when you go out?
Is he smoking out there?
He doesn't, darling. You never go for a walk.
There and back again. See how far it is? Are we having any tea? They gone to Ceylon to pick it fresh.
Lovely girl, Jeannie James.
Jeannie Witt as was.
Jeannie Witt as was.
What you doing? What you doing?
It's all right, love. It's all right.
What you doing?
You're all right. You're all right. You're all right. Hands that two dishes are as soft as your face. Mild green fairy liquid. Hands that do dishes are as soft as your face. With mild green fairy liquid.
Is that him? Is he coming now?
Oliver? Oh, we'll be back in a minute.
Oh, not Oliver. Not Oliver. Larry? Where's Larry?
Go, Dad. You ready for a couple of weeks' holiday with us?
Kettle's on. Lunch is ready.
It after the morning he's had.
Here you are, Dad.
Oh.
And here's a nice cup of tea, too.
Everything my heart desires. How will I manage the stairs?
You don't have to. Your bed's right here.
And we've made the downstairs live out of bounds to everyone except you. You've got your own loo, basin and mirror. And I've put a little cabinet in there for your shaving gear.
Home from home.
You couldn't have taken a shower anyway with the plaster.
Let alone a bath. If you're unhappy about sleeping downstairs...
No, it's fine. Sensible. I should have realised.
We can put you upstairs.
No, I don't want to go upstairs. This is lovely. Where'd you put your dining table?
It's in pieces, in the shed.
You've been to a lot of trouble. You're really good to me, both of you. I just didn't think.
You all right?
Yeah, I'll just finish this off and start my physio.
Well, don't forget, the French windows from your bedroom lead straight down into the garden.
All right, yeah. Hi-ho, Silver and me doing our physical jerks on the patio, eh? That's what I call the physio at hospital, you know. The physical jerk.
Millie, will you for God's sake stop doing that?
Granddaddy!
Why aren't you at college?
I wanted to see Gandhi. Hey, look at you, already dipping your tonsils in the tequila.
What have you done to your nose?
Oh, no. Oh, not that, no. Oh,
how sick is that? You look geezer gamps.
That's been hanging out of your septum.
Can I grab something to eat?
All your nasal bacteria straight up your grandfather's nose.
You're meant to be studying, miss.
You and Mum took the whole day off.
I suppose I'll be running you back to college.
Millie, hand out the plate.
See? I end up doing all the work.
Oh, yeah.
When you become a qualified beautician, will you give me one of those celebrity makeovers?
You have to be a celebrity first.
He already is. How many octogenarians do you know with a nose ring?
Yeah, in a way.
Let me squeeze past and take your arm.
No, I'm all right. I can manage.
No, if you fall again.
I can manage.
Let me...
I can manage. Come in, I'm decent.
I don't care if you're not, you don't frighten me.
What time are you up in the morning?
Well, the alarm goes off at 7, but you don't have to get up then. Just get up whenever, before or after.
Well, not before, unless I have to.
Well, you're not going to disturb us.
Oh, still.
Dad, please, don't be a guest. We'll just end up dancing around each other.
This sodding ankle. You miss a stair and your whole life goes under plug hole.
It's only for a bit.
The ghost of Christmas past, Christmas present, Christmas still to come.
Sorry?
Good night, Ollie. Thanks for everything.
Night.
Thank you.
coming a bit louder.
He needs his sleep.
He's mutton Jeff anyway.
I'll be asking the minister responsible what they're playing at shortly.
Did he pay the visa bills?
Mm-hmm.
Okay.
With the car service, the house insurance and Millie's fees, what do you think?
Well, she'll pay us back when a loan comes through.
I paid off half the balance.
So we get stung for the interest.
Maybe you should tell your dad about Summer House.
What about it?
Well, last month's extras were nearly £100.
Well, we'll take care of it till he's home and settled. And when social services sort his cash out, maybe he'll get all that sort of stuff covered anyway.
I could just see that. £17 for hairdressing. Miss a couple of rollers and squirt of spray.
No, thanks. Just had one.
Larry! You're home. You all right? Where's Genie?
I see they got rid of that bloody striker.
Call him a striker? He never struck a goal in his life.
Well, it's all penalties now, isn't it? You got any milk at your place?
Well, I don't think I'll get to any matches this season.
You'll have to get satellite.
Look at this place. He's littered it with grab rails, handles. He's taken all me rugs up.
Is she all right?
She's away with the fairies, Morris. I don't know who it is sitting in that high chair thing up Summer House. Is it a bird? Is it a plane? No. It's Jeannie James in someone else's clothes. She had some other woman's frock on this morning. I knew she looked wrong. Bloody hell.
They kept doing that with Polly.
That's why she's so... She hasn't got all her stuff around her. She'll be better when I get her home. Tell you what, did you get rid of Polly's wheelchair?
Part of the 5-year plan. It's down the shed. Do you want it for Jeannie?
Oh, talk sense. What does she want with the front row of the football, eh? Well, I can't make the stands with this leg, can I?
And you'll need someone to push you.
Thanks, Morris. Every cloud, as they say.
Ah, it's a combination. The players you've got, the mix of attack and defence, youth and experience.
Who picks the players?
And luck.
Yeah, it starts with the manager, you see.
They should get rid of all that Premier League nonsense, too.
It's just the same as the old First Division.
It's all money now. Back then it was skill.
Back when? Remind me when Swindon last won the Cup.
Good club, Swindon is.
You done your physio?
Yeah, and I climbed the stairs back at home and I took your mother all round the gardens.
You went back home?
Yeah.
Bloody hell, Dad, anything could have happened.
Anything could happen here.
Well, you don't have to climb the stairs here.
Did you know your mother was put in some stranger's club?
I had another tumble.
Well, I'm not going to make a habit of it. Are you listening? Some other woman's flock.
Thank you.
Just because you didn't recognise it.
Well, I've washed and ironed them enough.
You hear this? He's been home.
No. I was the purchaser from Iris Lane. She's dropped out. That's the whole chain wrecked.
Up and down the bloody stairs.
Well, he survived. Goodbye, commission.
I brought some of her bits and bobs to take over tomorrow. I'm not having her looking like Awful Annie. She's very particular about her clothes, you know that.
I say they're all at it anyway. Staying at home till they're 30. 40, God knows how long.
Well, if you're daft enough to cook his meals and wash his knickers.
He gets no fancy treatment. Eats what we eat, goes without.
And who does his ironing?
Just the odd shirt, while I'm doing ours. You wait till your Michelle turns up on your doorstep. You try turning her away.
Recent history reveals that previous Home Secretaries have shared the same preoccupations.
Ah, my old friend Mr. B. I met him once, you know, before his fall from grace. I said to him, David, let me give you the wisdom of my experience as a once promising engineer.
You queued up behind him once at a railway station.
In the days when I had a proper job.
What's face ache on about?
The so-called war against terrorism.
Yes, it is, man.
He's all right.
Educated idiots, all of them. What do you think he looks like?
He's blind, Dad.
Well, I know that. Didn't say he wasn't, did I? I know he's blind. What does he think he looks like?
Was there something you wanted to see?
Well, we could catch the tail end of the football if we're quick.
Do you not need your walking frame anymore?
We've party company, Silver and me. I took him out to the Prairies, slapped his backside, and off he ran.
He said you should use it for the first few days.
Yeah, it'll be fine. He'll find his old herd and spend the rest of his life roaming free. Bloody hell! Crystal Palace? Is there no football?
I like the way he says he's brought a few of our old bits and bobs. It's that old army suitcase of his bulging.
She's only got one wardrobe, one drawer.
Ah, well, leave him to it. That skinny matron can sort him out. Here you go.
Thank you. We forgot the case. Millie was out last night with all her... girlfriends. All bare midriff, full of life. Can you imagine what your mother would have said if you'd gone out with your belly button open to all weathers, eh? Now, we're going to do... Oh, stop this bloody leg. Right, now, hold your hands up, darling. That's it, arms up. I have to go right over your head, I think, love you. Hi, my darling. Touch the sky. Good girl. Right, right over your head now. There we go. And that's it. That's never your slip. I'd be ashamed to put you in an old rag like that.
Your wife was very agitated yesterday, and the girls had a struggle getting her to the loo, maybe.
She gets agitated. She gets like that. It doesn't mean you can just manhandle her.
I'm sure no one manhandled her.
She's a bit confused, but she still hurts and feels.
Of course. Mr. James, your wife is underweight.
Pot and kettle, love.
Oh, well.
Anemia can cause bruising at the slightest...
Why don't you try wet towels? They say they don't leave a mark.
If you're accusing me or my staff of deliberately abusing your wife...
I think we should all be very careful what we say just now.
Yes, I am accusing your staff. I'm bloody well accusing your staff! And don't you tell me to be careful. I've a son older than you.
I don't know, love. They just asked me to get over there ASAP and remove him. Oh, Christ, no. I don't want to see her arm, Dad.
I want you to. Come on.
We can't have you going into the residence area, upsetting them.
Can you stop me? Can you stop a husband seeing his wife?
I don't want to do this, Dad. She's my mum. I don't want to go in there and bloody undress her. Look, I believe you. No one doubts you.
One of the care assistants reported the bruise this morning.
There you are, then.
We made a note in the nurse's book to be particularly careful with Mrs. James.
We're very experienced with Alzheimer's.
Your wife really is receiving the very best of care. Really.
He's worried she may not be eaten.
We're giving her fortified drinks and also...
Porridge with honey and cream, that's what she likes. Boiled eggs mashed with butter and pepper. I want to get her home.
No one's hurting her, Dad.
We're approved by the council. We get inspected. All our residents receive regular medical care.
Can I go back in there now?
Of course.
Well, you can see, bereft.
Of course. We just can't have those sort of accusations. If it had left this room, we would have had to take action. Company policy.
I'll just leave him a few more minutes and then take him home.
Let's get you a cup of coffee.
Thanks, Ella.
All in a day's work.
You can drop me off here.
Well, it's a good half mile.
I want to walk. I'll take it easy.
Thought we could have a cup of tea.
Just stop the bloody car, son. I want fresh air. Sorry they called you at work.
Not to worry.
You've been taking quite a bit of time off for... Me and your mum, are they all right about it?
They're not thrilled, but it'll be okay.
It won't happen again.
Dad, you look knackered.
Oh, well, they kept us up all night at Dunkirk. You look so lovely when you're sleeping, I was drinking you in.
You're out of practice.
Oh, first pint I've had in ages. Not being able to leave Jeannie.
We should make an evening of it then, before she comes home.
We'll do that.
What's that?
Happy hour.
That's pushing it a bit.
As opposed to the miserable as sin hour. I don't know what I'm laughing at. No Millie tonight.
Sunday lunch, if we're lucky.
What does she eat?
What do any of them eat?
They graze.
Oh. There should be in a wine bar somewhere, eyeing up the talent.
No, she won't. Perfectly happy with Chris.
Ah, Mr. Charisma.
He's all right.
He's all right. He hasn't got a lot to say for himself. Or anything, in fact.
Well, not all men are as full of themselves as the James boys.
She's got a tongue on her.
Don't you two gang up on me.
Oh, you get used to this, Dad. Another man in the house of women.
What will we start with today? Now, let's see. Where are we? Oh, look. The old Ford Consul, remember? We had a few of those, didn't we? Now, which one is that, eh? Jeannie? Remember, which one is... It's the big old white one, do you remember? It must be, what, 65, eh? Yes, there's Oliver, all dressed up for the Scouts. Have you met our Oliver, Mrs. Hart? He was a Queen Scout, you know. Spent half her life sewing badges on. Oh, Jeannie, not Her Majesty. Where are we? Oh, look, there's your dad. Look, showing off his run of beans. Looks a good year, doesn't it, Jeannie? Hey, love, can you look, love?
If you need slippers, love, ones that we can bung in the washer.
I want her dressed properly. I want her in her stockings, sitting in her frock properly. I want that rag off her knees.
We can't have your father here from 9 o'clock in the morning till 5 in the evening.
I didn't know he was.
I feed her, talk to her. Make sure she gets a cup of tea.
That's our job.
And we all know how well you do it. That Mrs. Hart can't lift a cup to her lips, but you stick it in front of her. 3 hours later, you take it away again. What hasn't gone over her lap, poor cow? Job done.
You spend every day here.
I do since the bruise. It's a wonder they're not all incontinent. You never take them to the loo.
We have a routine.
I thought we were all happy about the bruise.
Delirious. Once every 8 hours, whether they need it or not.
Dad, you can't spend all day every day here.
We can't have a male visitor sitting in a twin bedded room all day long.
Then she can come home right now.
She can't.
She's incontinent, Clary. She's barely walking.
I'll get help in.
We tried that. A home help for a few hours each week, that's it.
We had a terrible job getting her in here. If you take her out...
We'll have to find somewhere else for her.
Your wife has Alzheimer's. There are very few nursing homes that will have her.
She's old and tired and not very well.
She's got Alzheimer's.
If she had a room of her own.
You couldn't afford it.
I've got savings.
Oh, God, I'm going home.
How much would it be for a room
Dad,
of her own?
Dad, you haven't got savings. You've got a few quid.
How much would it be for a room of our own?
Just enough to rule you out of most benefits.
£600 a week.
But the local authority would pay some of that.
But is there not an NHS?
For this. We haven't received Mrs. James' funding yet. We don't know how much more you'll have to make.
Do I owe the money, Oliver?
No, you don't.
If Mrs. James went into a single room, you won't get full funding for that. Nowhere like.
Come on, Dad. Let's get you home. Give you time to think things through a bit.
If I move in here, if we shared a double room...
You don't meet our criteria. I'm sorry.
What criteria?
You don't need nursing. You're not senile.
Oh, that's how you like them, is it? Gaga, so they won't tell tales.
Take him home, Mr. James. We'll be happy to see him between 2 and 5 every afternoon, but another time.
Five weeks ago, we were at home. Eating what we like, watching what we like, doing what we wanted to do. If it was sunny, she sat in the garden. No one bothering us. Mr. and Mrs. James.
And then you broke your ankle.
I'm going home tomorrow.
Fair enough.
And I'm selling that house.
Oh.
She's going to have a room of her own. She deserves that much, doesn't she? I deserve that much. To know she's getting the odd cup of tea. Somebody to hold her hand. If that's the only way she can get it, that's what
Someone
I'll do.
Shut him up, for God's sake.
And where would you live?
In a flat, one of those warden things.
There's a waiting list. You'd have to buy one.
Right, I'll do that then.
Of course you will.
It won't cost much less than you get for the house. And there's annual charges.
In sickness and in
shut
health.
Shut up, Dad! For God's sake, shut up! I'm trying to drive.
You know those new warden flats on the Carlton Road? You know how much they sell for?
The annual charge is more than you ever paid on your mortgage.
They put her to bed at 6, supper's at 4. That's a 16-hour night without a sip of water or a crumb of food.
I don't want to know.
It's big business. Your mother's just a column of figures on a balance sheet. The less she consumes, the better. That woman would have given her life for you, and you can't even raise your voice to help her.
I don't want to see her undressed. I don't want to know if she's wet herself. I'm sorry. I just want to know she's warm and calm.
You know when you lost your job at Fraser's?
They closed down.
Did you lose your balls as well?
I can't cope with this.
Yeah.
He's doing everything he can.
He's paying most people, isn't he?
Just the extras. Her hair, the laundry, the chiropodist.
I'll go to the bank tomorrow.
He won't take it. Larry, I sell houses for a living. I know what you'll get for your house, and it's not enough to set you both up.
As long as it sets her up.
Do you think he's...
bonkers?
No. Angling.
What for?
To stay here. I don't think I could...
Did he say that?
Well, how can he? Well, he's determined to sell up.
Love, your favourite, nice bit of rice pudding, made with brown sugar and noble butter. It's still warm. Don't say I never give you anything. Come on then, Jeannie. Come on, love. You know you want it, eh?
Want it?
Yeah. Well, we can take the skin off. It's the best part, you know. Ah, how about a nice banana, eh? See, I bought a fork. Twist it together. Yes, we have no banana. We have no bananas today. We've got onions and onions.
She won't want that, love. Not after roast chicken dinner.
Roast bloody chicken dinner? I bet you shoved it in front of her and then took it away again. I'll tell you what, sweetheart. I think they think I'm as daft as you. Very dapper. Don't you have a teapot?
Just make it in the mugs.
I'll bring you one from home.
Well, I think we've got one somewhere.
These council inspections.
What?
They're not going to be too stringent, are they?
Not even had a cuppa yet.
Neither's your mother. It'll be 2 hours before somebody takes her around a drink.
Well, maybe she's still asleep. I believe some people are.
Because if this summer house is the only place that takes people like your mum...
What?
If they close it down, the council, what are they going to do with everyone?
All right, Dad, they're all cruel bastards. They beat old people, they starve them, they abuse them. They grab them by the arms and shake them. And you know what? Sometimes I can see why they would be driven to it. Now the web of abuse has reached as far as the council. Great!
Stop it!
But she's having a rough time. I don't know what to do, what to say. Tell me what to do and I'll do it!
Let's help me!
So, Saturday. Forward to your football?
Fold this thing up for me. I can't get the hang of it at all. Let's be having you, Morris. You're in goal. I don't know what to do.
Swindon Town, is it?
Oh, yeah. And I just push myself, do I? Have some sense.
I can't believe it. Come and look. Now leave that and come and look.
our lovely new carpet.
It's taking the colour out.
Completely. Well, that takes some doing.
How the hell?
It's bleach. You can smell it.
Oh, stupid old...
He spilled his Horlicks, didn't he?
Well, why didn't he just say? We could have taken...
Oh, God!
Bloody hell! What do we do now?
Do you think...
What?
Does he know? I mean...
Know what?
I don't know. I mean, did he hide them there because... God, I don't know.
Happy Saturday afternoon. Hope his precious team lose 5-0.
So are you two mad with each other, or with me, or with Grandad?
Life.
Not mad at anymore.
I don't see why you can't sit down and eat that.
Well, then we could all enter the suicide pact together. No thanks. Hey, Gumpy.
Sorry, am I late?
How did they do?
I'll just go and tidy up.
That bad?
I didn't go.
I thought you'd arranged with Morris.
He's dead. Been dead a week. While I've been banging on his door, he's been lying in his coffin. Cremated yesterday.
We had the best of it. You're not missing much. And that's all the ceremony you get, my old mate. Well, your mother's looking a bit stronger today.
His time.
Yeah, but you're gonna miss him. I'm sorry.
Well, once he'd lost Polly, what had he got to live for?
Not Swindon Town anyway, eh?
Still,
the street's full of youngsters now, just while I'm selling.
Dad.
I went into your room to Hoover.
Ah, yes. Right, sorry about that.
If you just told us about it, I could have sorted it out.
Well, you've gone to bed. It was only a bit of milk.
No, it's bleached the colour out. There's a white patch.
Is there? I couldn't find the bleach. I thought the loo cleaner would be gentle anyway.
It's not just that.
Just...
Under your bed, you're hidden something.
I can't eat greens. Haven't been able to for years.
Well, just leave them.
Well, I mean, every meal is salad or peas or beans. I can't eat them.
Oh, you mean they give you diarrhea?
It's not always greens. Sometimes I just get it. I don't know why. Dear God. Are there any more bloody indignities coming my way?
We don't want to embarrass you.
Just don't
Don't try and hide them.
All right. I'll just breeze into the sitting room and say I've shit my pants again, shall I?
Have you seen a doctor?
I put the boiler on, have a bath, I look after myself.
We haven't got a boiler.
I was going to throw them out, but I forgot. I'm living in someone else's house. It's a bit of crap, Oliver. Just one more little bit of crap in a life that's suddenly full of it. I'm sorry about your car, Miss Sandy. I'll pay for whatever. The house went on the market today. My legs stopped aching. I won't be bothering you long. Oh, no. This is for Jeannie's things. If you need more...
How bloody insulting can you get?
I don't know, Oliver. You're the expert at that. Let me know about the carpet. Oh, I went to another estate agent. It's one less embarrassment.
They grab them by the arms and shake them.
Shut up!
They grab them by the arms and shake them.
All my staff have deliberately abusing your wife.
Shake them!
Don't bother knocking.
Stay with us.
No, thanks.
We both want you to stay. You can have our ensuite. Your privacy.
Does it matter in the great scheme of things? 2 or 3 pairs of St. Michael's a year.
We didn't know what to do. Please stay.
And put the money for the house in your bank, is that right?
What?
I mean, that's why you don't want your mum in her own room, hmm? Because you can see your inheritance frittering away.
Yeah, that's it. Because you leaving me that old house is going to sort all my problems.
Here you go, some other way.
You have no idea. You and your lifetime with one company, working your way up steadily through the ranks. Your nice little pension, your state pension, your smug little house.
And this isn't?
Well, this isn't going to be paid for till I'm 72. I'm still trying to make up for the endowment. I'll tell you what, Dad, you stick your inheritance. Give the whole lot away to summer house or to some cat's home. I don't care. I've never cared. That's never come into it.
I'm sorry, I didn't mean it.
Because I'm in the lucky generation. When Mum goes, I've got you and your old age to look forward to. Because you're going to be around for years and years. And no one else is going to pay for it. I've got Millie's college to pay for. Because I can't see her saddled with the same sort of debts I've got, can I? Then I've got my old age to look forward to and Sandy's. Because we haven't got a bloody penny in the bank and precious little in the pension.
I'm sorry.
God, I've never put a foot wrong. I've worked hard, I've stuck with the same woman.
I'm sorry.
Project manager on multi-million pound project. Now, all day, every day I sit in front of a bloody VDU checking over planning proposals for half, exactly half what I used to earn.
If you retrained...
Oh, yeah, maybe I should have gone for telesales. Oh, no, sorry, forgot. Too old. So, yeah, Dad, I'm looking forward to your death and the windfall it's going to bring me. I can hardly wait. God, I'm at fever pitch because I might just get to pay off the credit cards. God, it's probably not enough of a motive to lace your Horlicks with cyanide, but still...
I want to cry for your mum. Hold a ceremony and say, this was her. But she's gone. I want to mourn her.
No.
It's honored 175,000, the house. That'll keep her in a single room for years.
Probably give you something towards it as well.
And then if we're both still around, I'll smack her on the head with a house brick and walk under a bus.
Sounds like a good plan.
So long as I do them in the right order.
Come and live with us, Dad. I'm sorry about that.
Oh, no, I can be an annoying old bugger.
No, it's me. Come and live with us.
Till I find a flat or something, then.
Just for a while. Very good of you, Aunt Sandy.
You all right?
Mm. Tired? It's all that hanging around at Dunkirk.
I mean, he knows as well as we do he'll never get a warden flowered.
You might.
What, as some sort of priority case? Not with this roof over his head, and you and me running round after him.
He's only thinking about Mum.
He could live for another 15 years. You fancy a centenarian in the dining room? You'd be in your 70s, you'd be gaga or bedridden or both. I want to look after him. I like him. I want to...
Nothing a bullet in the brain wouldn't put right.
How about a nice massage? The Millie Jane special. That nice?
Hmm.
Wait a minute, Grumps. Don't move. Don't move now. I won't be a minute.
Smell like a bunch of flowers.
Lavender.
Like someone's old granny.
I do miss her.
Yes.
It's not forever, is it?
We'll see.
I'm sorry, Grandy.
You know what she'd like? This. She'd love it if you could do this for her.
I will then.
Will you?
Maybe next week.
Right. That was very nice, Millie Molly.
Not had your Indian head massage.
Which is as well, I haven't got an Indian head.
I will go and see Gran. It's just that place.
I know. Not to worry, sweetheart. It was me that walked her up that aisle, not you. Eh? Blimey. It's a standing ovation. She'd be chucking flowers next. I'm kicked a peggy leedle lum with me extra leggy leedle dum. Wherever I go, through rain and snow, the people always let me know I'm kicked.
Touched it. Can have baked beans on toast tomorrow.
I don't do it like that. Oh, God. I don't know. Oh!
Every bloody morning. Now the bloody radio. My annual review today. I'm just gonna radiate youth and energy, aren't I?
Morning.
I won't bother with toast then.
You can have that.
No, 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 you're all right. You have it.
No, you have it, I'll do some more.
I don't want any.
Yeah. Thanks. Lovely day to have your plaster off.
I meant to be taking you.
I'll get a bus.
Did I say I would?
It doesn't matter.
I did that. Great.
I'll get a bus.
Look, he'll have to change. And if the hospital bus doesn't arrive...
For God's sake, I'll take him! How many more times?
Oh, I've got a letter about the house.
No time.
Good luck, Ollie.
I'll tell you on the way. You doing anything special today?
Hanging on to my job by my fingernails. Oh, for Christ's sake, you stupid old bastard!
Say to him this time. Mills! Millie! I'm off, if you want a lift. See you, Grandad. Two addresses for you, love. Standard Street and Hart Close.
Standard Street?
That's where you live.
I've just sold it.
So, Hart Close, is it number 7?
No. Not there, scrub that out.
We need a current address.
Oh, anything. Salvation Army, Windsor Castle. But not Hart Close.
Then grab them by the arms and shine them! Stupid old bastard! Shine them, bastard!
Doing still here? Have you been perched there all morning?
I called out, but they'd gone.
Oh, I love him. Nip and get him a sandwich from the kitchen. First on the list this afternoon, I promise. Doesn't know whether he's after all Martha. Oh, you wait there, dear.
I know where the plaster room is.
I don't think they're going to be back yet.
When thou wast young, thou walked where one would. But when you're old, you stretch forth your hands, and another shall carry you where you don't want to go, or words very roughly to that effect.
I'm not sure what...
Which is all very well and good, but not yet. And not me.
Oh. 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 Oh.
Someone's bought it. Just like that. So we're rich. There's more money in the bank now than... comes free. I'll be here every day, 9 o'clock till tea time. That'll be good, won't it, eh? All those long shifts, weekend working. 30 years without a day off sick. So, it all paid off in the end, eh? Hey, Jeannie? There you are. There you are, darling. There we are.
Dad, it's me. Called the home, no sign of him. Came as usual and left as usual.
What happened this morning?
Nothing.
You were going to give him a lift.
Yeah, maybe they kept him in at the hospital.
No, they'd have rung.
He's gone down the canal.
Sorry?
You weren't to know till tea time. He wanted to get something sorted before you got there.
Where?
Dunno, just said the canal.
Well, I wish you'd told... He's killed himself. My God.
Shut your mouth. There's a bus coming. Whole families lived on them.
If you're doing this to make me feel bad...
Feel what you like. Come the fine weather, this will be me.
Bloody won't.
It'll take a few months to put her right. But it won't be the first time a small boat's saved my life.
What are you on about?
Did it not happen then, this morning?
I came home early to talk to you.
Can't be talked away, son. It'll always be there. That will. Not just the summer, either. As long as it doesn't snow, I'll be there. Weekends, evening.
Christ.
Like the valve on a pressure ticker. Potter about a bit. Make a pot of tea. Bake and butty. Read the paper. Give you and Sandy a break.
Right, enough. Lock up and come home.
Go to the loo when I want.
How'd you leave a boat? Do we... Pull up the gangplank or what?
Hey, leave it, Oliver!
Look at the state of this! You pay good money! money for this crappy...
I dare say I smell a mildew, but there's worse things.
Shut up, Dad.
At least I'll see Jeannie most of the day. Oh, what happens when I'm not there, of course?
Is there a padlock?
Let's not think about that, will we?
Look at his bloody plywood!
I haven't finished up there!
Yes, you are.
The gas cylinder is changing.
You stay where you are!
You've no right to do this, Oliver.
Bloody kill yourself, you stupid old fart! Well, that would suit you, wouldn't it?
Leave that alone!
Bloody bacon sandwiches! Stupid idea, you know that! There's all sorts down here, kids, thugs!
Who should I fear most, Oliver? Them or you?
If you'd like further information or support following tonight's programme, please call the BBC Action Line on 08000 566 056. That's 08000 566 056. Lines open 7 days a week from 7:30 a.m. until midnight. All calls are free and confidential. Or visit the Comic Relief website at rednoseday.com.